Hello friends, Paulshinn from the Boomerest car channel on YouTube. Well, I'm on a mission this morning. It's a little bit different kind of a video. I'm here in the blue collar mobile on my way to Bob's to pick him up, and then we're headed to the San Francisco Bay Area. So you remember termite bait, that 1930 special delivery that I got running for Rich and Gloria Moore? Their plan was to hand it off to their adult son who lives down in the Los Angeles area and keep it in the family. So I got it running and driving. They took it home. They backed it into the garage under its own power, shut it off, and there it sat. A little bit before Christmas, the whole family came up from the Los Angeles area and they wanted to take pictures with it. They went to start it, couldn't get it started. Thing would not start. They called AAA, jumped it, still couldn't get it started. So they pushed it back in the garage, that was it. So Gloria reached out to me and said, hey, can you help us figure this out? We really want to send this thing home with our son. So that's the plan. We're gonna go figure out why that thing doesn't want to start. It's probably something real simple. It always is with the Model A. We're gonna get that thing running. I'm gonna show Jeff how to start it for one thing, and maybe even show him how to drive it. And then the plan is for him to take his dad to a very special class. So let's get going.
Ready to go?
Yeah.
Ready to go fix a Model A?
Let's go for broke.
Okay. Oh, do this for a couple more hours, we'll be there.
I'm gonna have to hold it for 2 hours?
Yeah.
The guy?
Am I the guy?
You're the guy.
Very nice.
That's the guy right
the
there.
The guy.
Every time I'm troubleshooting a Ford Model A will not start problem, I always start with battery voltage, checking the battery voltage and the battery connection. So that's what I'm doing first. So in order to get to the battery in a Ford Model A, you need to pull the battery cover. Or in this case, since termite bait's built kind of funny, you need to pull the entire floorboard to be able to get to both battery terminals easily. So termite bait has a 12 volt negative ground system. So I saw 12 volts at the battery. That's good. Next, I'm going to go under the hood and I'm going to check to make sure I still have 12 volts at the nut, that 5/8 nut on top of the starter switch. Then I'm just going to keep going downstream one after another, make sure I still have the same voltage all the way down the line. So all the voltage tests I'm doing so far are just referencing voltage to ground. This doesn't actually test the ground itself. That'll come later, but these tests here, what I'm doing is I'm checking for the correct voltage all the way downstream. So starting there at the battery, then working my way to the starter switch, then from there the terminal box, both sides of the coil, the other side of the terminal box, all of that is just to check a voltage itself to make sure that I don't have a voltage drop with a loose connection somewhere in the system. Now where I found the actual problem here is coming up.
You ready for fire in the hole?
Yep.
I got my hand on it.
Sure.
Okay. Alright, here it comes.
Smell.
Smell like gas?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good.
Don't choke it yet.
Okay, listen close. Right here. Did you hear that little pop? That pop came from right below my feet. Right where the ground connection is, where the battery connects to the chassis. That's when I knew, okay, we got a bad ground here.
I don't see any lights. Are there lights?
Nope. We got nothing going on.
Okay.
You did have a blinker.
I did. So the blinkers work, but they're on a different circuit. They're not going through the ammeter.
Yeah.
We have a bad connection somewhere.
Yes, we do.
Okay. Let's get this out of the way.
And that makes sure that I get a good ground.
You realize the gas that I put in this has almost tripled in value?
It's worth more than the car now.
It is. Yeah, now like if you go on to KellyBlueBook.com, yeah. And they have you put in the
you know, year, make, model, and the color, yeah, and the trim level. Now they put how much gas is in the tank. Because that will change the value drastically.
There you go.
They're laughing because it hurts.
Yeah.
Oh, this is loose.
Is it?
Oh, yeah. It must have jiggled loose on the ride home or something.
Well, not since it corroded between the two.
No, there's no corrosion at all. That's it's right. Clean. It's just loose. So the bolt that holds the ground strap to the frame, I cleaned around that and cleaned the paint off. And
you didn't tighten it up.
Knowing that termite bait needs to be ultra reliable for Jeff, I finally decided, why don't we just do what we usually do when we're on a tour and this happens to somebody? Let's go to the auto parts store, we'll buy an extra battery cable, and we'll put a cable from the ground point directly to the engine itself. So that's pretty much what we're going to do. But while I was here, I also wanted to get some extra fuses for the fuse holder we installed on the starter switch.
Hey, you know what though? If all else fails, we can just run from the battery straight to the clamshell like we did on the red coupe. That'll work.
Okay, what else? Hey. Nuts and bolts.
Now they got music. Now we get a copyright strike. All right. Let's get back in the blue collar mobile and get back to work.
Gas is a little pricier here than it is back home.
Well, of course. This is Bay Area. A high rent district,
you can
afford it.
Yeah, as hillbillies, we can't afford that.
And back to the garage. I wanted to go ahead and pull the floorboard because I wanted to replace both of the battery cables. So since this is a 12 volt system, it doesn't need the huge battery cable that we would normally use with a 6 volt system. So I took the new cable and ran it through the inside of the old cable so I could still use the same holder and the clamp that holds the cable onto the flywheel housing and installed everything. It looked kind of pretty, but with all new cables. So now there's nothing in the system that's old or corroded or anything. It's all brand new stuff, shiny, good connections. Then I went ahead and added the extra cable from the ground point on the chassis where we normally have it on a Model A and ran that directly to the transmission. So I took a close-up so you can see the extra cable and where I connected it to the ground point on the chassis here. Same bolt, made sure it was tight. Now it's time to give it a try.
There's no floor here, so I can put my feet out to stop me.
Huzzah! Of course it starts. Once you have a good ground and you got the proper voltage to everything, especially the coil, of course a Model A is going to run. It's the simplest car on the road.
You gotta get fed first.
Fed? Yeah, you heard right. Their plan was to feed us. Oh my gosh. Talk about nice people.
What did you got a degree in college, didn't you?
I did.
That didn't do no good here.
No, absolutely not. No, I learned pretty quick.
Well,
I
you
think
know,
Paul's YouTube channel is going to be my major watching.
Yeah. If my YouTube channel is major watching, did you guys hear that?
Yep.
So my next plan is to finish putting the car back together enough to be able to take it for a drive. Then I'm going to take some time here and I'm going to show Jeff all the steps of starting the car both warm and cold.
Feel the spark of it, so go ahead and pull it down and feel, you can almost feel the notches right there, almost. So all the way up, now pull it all the way down so you know where that is, okay? Now about halfway in between is where you're gonna end up after it starts.
Okay.
Okay, so all the way up. Now put your foot on the accelerator. Now see, there's two buttons down there. The one on the right is just a footrest.
Okay.
It's fixed.
Yep.
The one on the left, you can push that one and feel that's the one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so just lightly put your foot on it, pull that down until you feel it go down about that much. That's about where you want it.
Yeah.
Okay, you turn the gas on, which it's already on.
It's on.
good.
You don't have to worry about the choke right now.
Yep.
It's warmed up. So turn the key on. Hit the starter. It should start. Make sure you're out of gear. Okay. Starter's all the way up at the top.
Look at that. Jeff's first Model A start. You got to be there to see it. So after this, we went over the Model A a few more times. I had him start it, stop it a few more times. And then we went for a drive, and I showed Jeff how to drive it. Now, why don't I have footage of that? Because you know what's not safe? Is filming while you're teaching somebody how to drive a Model A. So anyway, we got back home, and we took a few shots. The family wanted to take some photos together just for old time's sake, for memories. So we did that, and they even included Bob and myself in the pictures. That was so nice of them. What a nice family. Then they invited us in. Then this is when we got the real surprise.
That's it.
This is where we really got a chance to meet the family. Everybody treated us like we were one of them. It was so welcoming. The food was delicious. And now I officially work for food. But we got the story of what's really going to happen. Jeff's going to use termite bait. Not just play with it like a toy. It's actually going to get used.
How come you get a dessert?
This is a thanks to Mr. Paulshinn. That we are driving in the hills of Pleasant Hill, moving into Lafayette, I believe. Just passed over the city sign of Lafayette. And Jeff is driving, and Opa is in the passenger seat. It is no longer a toy, it's a vehicle. Look at that baby go.
I wanted to seal the deal for our new Model A owner friend, so I made a call.
Hi, Ed. This is Ed Tolman. He's the president of the Pomona Valley chapter of the Ford Model A Club of America. How are you today, Ed?
Doing pretty good. It's nice to have a little more sunshine in the evening.
Oh, it's gorgeous, isn't it? I love this daylight yeah. savings.
Extra hour.
Hey, you know what happened? Just yesterday, I was working on a Model A again. And if you remember the video I did a little while back on termite bait, that special delivery.
Yes, I do recall.
Well, that was for Rich and Gloria Moore. Their plan was to hand that car off to the next generation, their son, Jeff. Jeff lives near you. So termite bait, as we speak, it's on its way down to your area where it's going to live permanently.
Oh, wow. Well, that's awesome.
Yeah, I wanted to know if I could hook you and Jeff up so that Jeff could join the Pomona Valley Club.
Well, yeah, we're going to have to tent his car, though, for first, I think. Yeah, that'd be awesome. We have a really fun club, an aging club like most are. It's been kind of exciting. So last month in February, we had our second annual Sweetheart Tour. We had 8 Model A's and about 8 other vintage vehicles, some Chevys and various other cars, and had a blast. Anyway, we had 2 new members join, which was awesome. And then we had just this last week, a week ago Monday night, had a meeting where somebody came, first time, just bought a Model A not too long ago, and he's looking to for help to restore it, and he joined the club. And so we're actually making, you know, we're gaining members, which is great.
I can't wait for Jeff to meet you. And how long have you been president of that club?
6 long years.
6 years. Good for you.
Yeah,
you
and I,
you and I have both served as presidents of our respective clubs for a long time. I know how that is. Yeah. And how hard it's been to keep a club going through COVID. So good for you guys for staying active and for attracting new members. And of course, you get this member by proxy.
Yeah, we sure appreciate
it. We're handing them off to you. You know,
that's awesome.
Treat them well for me, will you please?
Will do. Will do. Awesome. Well, it's funny too, because I have a machine shop in Pomona.
Yeah.
So if he lives in Pomona, we're going to be neighbors.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
All right. Well, good. I'm going to give him your number, and hopefully you guys can hook up soon. And wait till you see termite bait. Now this car, I didn't do a whole restoration on it, but I got it running and driving, and now I'm handing it off to him, and they have taken it for a drive. He took his dad today to his dad's Alzheimer's class. He drove him in the Model A today.
Yeah.
So awesome. Yeah. So he's well on his way. So it's running and driving. It just needs that extra 5%. That's all it needs. And then I'm sure you guys are going to have a great time with him.
Yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely. We're going to love to have him.
That's awesome. Thank you, Ed. Thank you so much. I knew I could count on you.
Okay, Paul. Take care. Thanks. Bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.